Hey everyone and welcome to SkillCap. My name is Dr. Zora and in today's video, we're going to be providing the ultimate beginner guide to one of the most pivotal roles in Valorant, and that is the Sentinels. For those who aren't familiar with who the Sentinels are and what they do, Valorant describes them as defensive experts who can lock down areas and watch flanks, both on attacker and defender rounds. This class type tends to be the best defensive agents. These characters will either hang back or lay traps to watch your team's flank when attacking. The current Sentinels available at the time of this video are Cypher, Killjoy, and Sage. Each of these agents play the same role, however they each have their own unique way of fulfilling that role. We're going to break down how to use Sentinels the right way and how you can take advantage of each Sentinel's abilities to absolutely dominate your opponents. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. Going right into our question of the day for y'all, since we're discussing about Sentinels in particular, which Sentinel is your favorite to play? My personal favorite is Sage, and I'm sure there's plenty who are with me on that, but also plenty who enjoy Killjoy or Cypher just as much. We're curious as to which Sentinel is the most popular at this time, so make sure to drop those comments down below. To start things off, let's break down what the role of Sentinels really is. Like we mentioned earlier, Sentinels really shine in their defensive prowess. Their abilities really work well at trapping and stalling enemies down, thus making it harder for them to make aggressive plays onto you. Along with that, Sentinels really shine at watching your team's back. If you use your abilities right, you and your team will never get flanked if you have a Sentinel. Keep these two aspects in mind when playing a Sentinel. Your goal with these agents are more so for defense, where you're stalling enemies out and watching your team's back. If you accomplish these two roles, you're going to be well on your way to being an insane Sentinel player. Now that we know the role of the Sentinels, we can begin breaking down each agent, and we're starting off with none other than Sage. As a Sentinel, Sage really shines at providing stopping power to delay enemies. She has two abilities to accomplish this, her barrier orb and her slow orb. In most scenarios, you're going to want to use your barrier orb first to block off a choke point to delay a push from the attackers or to delay the rotations from the defenders. If the enemy tries to push through your wall, that is when you're going to want to use your slow orbs to delay them further. So always try to use your barrier orb first before your slow orbs, as your wall will delay enemies much more efficiently and may even deter the enemy from trying to push further through. Now there will be scenarios where you aren't close enough to place down a barrier orb, so in that case using the slow orbs first would be appropriate since you can shoot those at further ranges. To give some examples, a common area you want to defend with Sage is the middle on split. So you're going to want to wall that off right away if you hear any enemies approaching there. If the enemy tries to break down your wall and they want to continue pushing through, that's when you want to use your slow orbs to slow them down further. Now let's say the enemy doesn't push through middle and they go straight through to garage instead. In that scenario, you likely won't be able to run fast enough to wall off garage before they push. In this case, using the slow orbs first would be your best bet. On attack, you want to try to use your walls to block off rotates like we mentioned. For example, some areas to wall off on split are screens in heaven on the A site, vents on middle, and spawn on the B site. If you have the time available, you can also drop a wall in heaven after you push through it. All these walls are meant to block off the defender's vision and stall, making it harder for the defenders to retake the site and defuse the spike. Sage's other abilities are Heal and Resurrection as your ultimate. These are both very valuable abilities to have. If you do have them available, you're going to want to play further back and more defensive so that you can heal or revive your teammates after they get into their initial fights. These abilities can give you a man advantage or give your teammate a good chance of winning another duel. If you die early when you have these abilities available, then your teammates won't be able to get that extra health or extra life, and they'll have a less likely chance of winning the round. Speaking of winning rounds, if you want to learn how to maximize your chances of winning every round you play in Valorant, then make sure to go to skillcap.com to unlock our hyper improvement system that'll teach you everything you need to blast through the rankings in Valorant. The link will be provided in the description below. Moving on, we have Cypher. Cypher is one of the masters of defense and really takes on that Sentinel role. All his abilities are meant to gather information and delay an enemy's push. Because of this, Cypher really shines on the defender side, however he still has his uses on the attack side as well, which we'll break down. On the defender side, you want to always start off with setting up a good defense before the round starts. First, pick a site to defend. In most maps, Cypher really does well on the B sites, with the exception of Icebox, however he isn't limited to just that and can be flexible. Now that we picked the site, we want to set our traps in common areas that the enemy is going to try to push through. There are a lot of options here, so make sure to observe where the enemy likes to push through and place your traps there. For example, on the B side of split, you'll want to place a trap close to the end of garage. This is a good place to start off with, as most players will try to rush in without checking for traps at that point. As a rule of thumb, we recommend placing a cypher cage on top of your traps too. By doing this, you will blind your enemies and make it hard for them to fire back at you while the enemy gets stuck in your trap. Cypher's traps will outline enemy locations, making it easy to spray through the cage for an easy kill. Another good spot to put a trap could be up at mail, as that's a common area that players will try to push through to get onto the B site. This will be more to support your teammates as you'll want to be more on the B side itself to defend. A third spot that can help yourself though is right next to the bulletin board, as it's almost guaranteed an enemy will run through there to push the B side. Same idea, you want to get a cage up as well and go for the easy spam when the enemies get caught in your trap. Now let's go into Cypher's other abilities. Cypher's spy cam is really good for trying to get information on enemy locations early. You'll want to place this deep into a choke point to cover that area out. If enemies don't show up, you can get close to the other areas on the map and constantly check back and forth on the camera to double check that no one is there. You can also place your cameras nice and high on the site you're defending on to get a bird's eye view on the enemy. When you see them, you can mark them and shoot them down for an easy kill. Rather than getting frags though, the emphasis with this ability is more to find enemy locations and call out where enemies are going to be pushing. Once their locations are found and you see them pushing in, that is also an indicator for you to trigger your cages and get ready to frag players that get trapped. Cypher's last ability is Narrow Theft, where he can utilize a dead player from the enemy to identify where the remaining players are. This will help with rotating your team to the right locations and should be used whenever you get a chance to. The exception is when you have a huge number advantage on the round or the enemy is on a save round, where using the ultimate will be less beneficial for you. These are just a few ideas on how to utilize Cypher's abilities on the B side of Split to other maps and areas, and you can also change up the setup as needed based on how the enemy plays. Now on the attack side, Cypher is really going to be best for watching the flank. After picking a site to hit, you always want to put a trap wire on the opposite site so you can tell if you're getting flanked or not. From there, you want to use your spy cam to check certain areas of the map to clear it out prior to pushing onto that area. You can also use it to check your flank if you don't have trap wires available. Cyber Cage is going to be for quick delays and vision blocking. For example, if you plan to push up ramps, then blocking off A short with a cage would be a good idea to make sure you don't get crossfired. Last but not least, we have Killjoy, who plays fairly similar to Cypher, however her abilities are a little different. Killjoy also shines in creating a good setup to defend a site. Like Cypher, she also shines more on the B sides of maps, but her kit tends to be much more versatile and she can rotate between the sites. On defense, you want to place her turret in a position where it can spot out attackers early before they can fully push through the site. You'll then want to place your Nano Swarms in a position where the attackers are likely to push, just like you would with Cypher's tripwires. Once you feel like the enemy is pushing after your turret has spotted them out, then trigger the Nano Swarms and peek to take them out while they're trying to avoid your abilities. You can also place your alarm bots in one of the choke points that the defenders have to hit. This will tag them and put a vulnerable debuff that will increase the amount of damage that they'll take with abilities and bullets. Same idea again, if the enemy triggers your alarm bot, you want to peek out and shoot them out. This now leaves Killjoy's ultimate. You want to use this ability to stall an attacker's push. Make sure to position this in a way so that it will force enemies back. For example, putting it under rafters here can be a good spot, as it'll be difficult for the attackers to shoot it out and it'll still cover A towers and A short. Another option is the back of sight, where it's hard for enemies to rush it down before it goes off if you're defending it well. Last but not least, we have the attack side. You'll want to use the turret like Cypher's trap wires, so place it in an area where it can be helpful to check your flank. Example would be putting it here outside of spawn so that anyone trying to flank through ramp or sewers will get caught out. You can also use Killjoy's alarm bot to achieve the same purpose if you aren't able to position your turret so that you can check everything. From there, Nano Swarms and Lockdown are going to be more for clearing out the site. For example, you could use it in Garage to push the B defenders back, and you can also use Nano Swarm to clear out those pesky angles that the defenders could be at. If we take a detailed look, you'll notice that Killjoy and Cypher play very similar to one another, and hence we recommend learning both these agents so you have an extended agent pool. These two agents in particular really represent what playing a Sentinel is really like, so if defense is your forte, then make sure to learn them by implementing the tips we just mentioned to every map. We hope you enjoyed this video, and if you haven't already, make sure to comment below which Sentinel is your favorite to play. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to get more premium guides just like this one with one goal in mind, helping you become a better player. We here at Scout Cat want to thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next. I'm Dr. Zora, and good luck out there.